Okay, y'all getting a little bit of a two-for-one special this week. I am going to lump in some of the after-show lives with my thoughts of Bobby I Love You per reunion season. I mean, not season, but part two. So, part two was 50 minutes long, but I think this whole video, including with the clips, is going to be no more than an hour because I'm drained. It's been a very exhausting week, not only because of all the tumultuous stuff going on in my personal life. Once again, y'all ignore the handsome beard tease. Although, I guess this shit normal right now. I'm going to start calling myself him from Darngone Powerpuff Girls. Because every time I come up on here, I be giving y'all Darngone Uncle Clifford tease, honey. But neither here nor there. Also, condolences for the folks down to the Colorado Club. It's like, we just can't have no... It's like they trying to roll our rights back. We can't even go to the club without Darngone risk getting Darngone. And then now you got people attacking T.S. Madison. And I'm wondering, y'all give me y'all thoughts. Do y'all want my opinions on that situation? The folks coming after T.S. Madison for giving her opinion about the folks trying to frame the attack on Shaquille. Once again, rest in peace to her as well. But they tried to frame a narrative that it was one of the T-girls that attacked her. And people was going with that narrative. And because T.S. Madison shut it down, you have some prominent hotel Darngone conscious folks. Some folks that I know, but and it's like I have a love-hate relationship with some of them. And I don't mind calling them out. If y'all want that breakdown, y'all definitely feel free to tell me. Because I don't mind going in when people's wrong. And I done seen quite a few people. Once again, I don't mind going at anybody when they wrong. And that stuff, and it's like, girl, you was 50-something years old. You shouldn't you Darngone be playing with the grandbaby or something? Why is you up on here Darngone want to go in for 6 hours? And then she did not one but two live streams. And she know who I'm talking about. And I'm not even going to mention her name right here because I don't want the narrative framing that I'm trying to clout chase. Although, hell, you only got like 20,000 subscribers. I don't know what there's to clout chase off of. But you know that would be the first thing thrown out there. Oh, Diva Juan trying to clout chase on somebody's name. Even when I mention this person directly, honey, I'm not going to put them in my meta tag data. I'm not even going to put them in the title of my Darngone description. I might not even put her face, but y'all would know. I'm going to say her name in the video, though, so y'all would know exactly who I'm talking about if y'all want me to do the video, but that's about it. But anyways, let's get to this mess with Darngone Bobby. So we start off where we left off. Bobby's going at Darngone Allen Boy, all this, that, and the third. Just a hot, funky mess, honey. And then the infamous Darngone read about the D being small. I was like, honey, that sugar honey iced tea was funny in the moment, honey. But we know that D ain't Darngone small. The fact that you already done alluded early on, because we done found out the game was more rigged than we thought. Now, we know that this ish was Darngone strategic and stuff. But, honey, I didn't think that they already had it set out where Allen Boy was going to be the winner for day one. And then this was the real game. Now, I knew that there was some messing around going on in the house. Diva Juan called it. But God darn, Bobby, the first night, you did that whole scene making it seem like Darngone rerun was on the couch. And your hoish behind Darngone let Darngone rerun tap it the first night? Like, you couldn't even wait 72 hours from him getting in the house. Now, that's some low-down, dirty, Darngone Scorpio type of ish. The first night? Child boo. Meanwhile, they gonna put an orange cover over on this Darngone couch that Darngone Tracks is on. Because the Darngone Dimitri antics throwing water on folks, honey. They gonna rearrange folks around. This don't make no Darngone sense. And the security guard is just one side. Like, I'm trying to figure out, like, why is they security even letting Bobby roll up on? See, it's the favoritism for me. Like, this ish that I don't like. Like, how in the world you letting the darn going other folks run up on folks? It's like, I don't give a darn if this is called the Bobby Show. They even allowed Bobby to slap the heck out of Jameson, and they didn't even darn going run up to even defuse that situation immediately. But as soon as Jameson get up, it's like they want the darn going to try to detain Jameson, though, aka Island Boy. Same thing with darn going Hot Wheels later on in the show, where they brought out Davion, and he called himself rolling that wheelchair towards Davion, and they kindly darn going turned that wheelchair around. It's like, well, shoot, he can't do too much from the darn going wheelchair. Only thing you got to do is this darn going kindly move out the darn going way. It's not like he got the motorized version like Hot Wheels like Rolling Ray. And my thing is this, at this point, why doesn't darn going Hot Wheels got a motorized wheelchair? Now that wheelchair can't be too expensive. I mean, and then he said he had to pay for the ankle bracelets Alpha Insurance. Maybe that's why, because he said that cost $15,000. And it's like, well, shoot, if you got $15,000 to get the darn going bracelets for your legs to help you maneuver and stuff, to help, you know, strengthen your legs and regain mobility, you telling me you couldn't have gone and got a payment plan for a $2,000-$3,000 motorized wheelchair? Cause I know there's a site where you could have darn gone did a firm AFFIRM, and you could have put like $200 down and made payments over some time for the darn gone wheelchair or something. Why you still got this darn gone wheelchair? But honey, that builds up arm strength, honey. Cause he just the. But neither here nor there, child. It was the contradiction for me where Bobby darn gone lies and said that darn gone Ray didn't spit on. I was like, first you trying to say he's your friend and he was the number one person you called. And then when it came to the Rolling Ray situation, you want to say, well, he just spit at you. Like, that makes it even better. And it's like, well, why would you even say that contradiction when darn gone Ray said it himself that he darn gone spit on him? We done seen the darn gone clip. Like, Bobby, honey, I wasn't darn going too offended by Jason saying, well, honey, are you drunk? And, honey, actually, Jason was being modest with saying that because it was giving darn going booger sugar teas, if you ask me, honey. And we now has confirmed that that's not even alleged. Bobby said he darn going does the darn going the nose candy, child. And for monetization reasons, honey, because I do plan on getting my monetization back, because you two want to be petty, right? You two done said, oh, Diva Wine, you make a little bit too much coin for the holidays off of these Bobby darn gone shows. Honey, they done snatched my darn gone monetization down for a month. So that's why y'all blessed the darn gone get this commercial free if you're watching this before December 16th. Now, for the ones that's watching this on the playback a month from now, honey, my monetization will be back, honey. I swear, YouTube get on my nerves. Every time I darn gonna get somewhere, they darn gonna throw a curveball at your girl, honey. I didn't get not one strike, not one darn going flag, but they want to take my whole monetization down for 2 to 3 videos. Ain't that some bullshit, y'all? But anyways, now they're giving us a montage of all the stuff that done happened, right? Dimitri and the darn gone back acting like he darn gone scared to even come out. And my thing is this, Dimitri, girl, for all this that you was talking about, you from New York and you from fashions and all this, that, and the third, you was talking ish about Big Bird. Girl, you looking the most bummy. And I love darn gone, Dimitri, but girl, it was giving me white bum teeth. Girl, you looked like the most pitiful darn gone a person there. It's like, you looked it totally out of place. You looked like, heck, you didn't even look like you could have been dressed to be in the darn gone audience, if you ask me, child. Child, your outfit alone played yourself, honey. Now, you made the excuse up the first time talking about you didn't have time to be in the house and you didn't get your, there was some lost luggage and all this, that, and third. That's why you only got 2-3 outfits. But, honey, this was filmed months later. Now I'm trying to figure out why at this point in the game you didn't have no change of clothes. You knew about this reunion weeks in advance coming up. Why didn't you go down to New York and get your old nice custom tailored suit, Mr. Fashions? Honey, just your appearance alone played itself, honey. If Big Bird wanted to be petty, honey, he could have darn gonna read you for fifth, honey. But it looked like you avoided Big Bird. You made up with the right people just in the nick of time, because leading up to this, honey, Dimitri done made, you know, his amends with nearly everybody for the most part. Heck, we even darn gone got Crush and darn gone Dimitri hugging it out or whatnot's child. But yeah, that's one thing that stood out to me. Another thing is, in the midst of darn gone Bobby trying to go at darn gone Allen Boy, he darn gone thought darn gone Rerun was going to get up and darn gone be his do boy, talking about handle this for me. Honey, Rerun sat Rerun sat there and paid Bobby just like, honey, you better get security to handle him. Honey, we no longer on the show no more. I ain't getting paid for this. I ain't got no problem with his ass. Time I darn gonna handle him. Child, bye. And then y'all done let it out that the relationship was fake. While y'all was darn gone faking that relationship, having people pay $14.99 just to have darn gone Rerun slap his hind parts up on your booty, honey, up in the shower. I might darn gone post that to my regular Diva Wine page. Y'all, if enough of y'all comment down below, I will repost that to my Diva Wine page. But y'all wasn't really missing nothing over there on the OnlyFans with Bobby and Rerun. Honey, a waste of $15, child. I'm glad I didn't even waste my money on that purchase. Now, Bobby, I did pay quite a bit for your darn gone stuff. I was an avid supporter, but honey, I wasn't paying for darn gone mediocreness, honey. Now, the video of you with the darn gone milking, honey, Bobby's old nasty freak, honey. Bobby puts the Scorpio in Scorpio, child. He got this one video where he's darn going doing a little bit of projectile with the milk in the hind parts of whatnots. And then he got one with darn going, I can't think of the darn going entertainer. I think it's Malik Joseph or something. Where it was some simulating play up in the shower that was a little bit more convincing or whatnot. That was entertaining. And then he had one with Raheem Shabazz that wasn't really hitting on nothing. Matter of fact, Bobby will make good for one of these darn gone LGBT shows where they give you a little bit of simulated action of the hanky-panky without really going there. Like, Bobby would do good on some of those shows. Based off of that OnlyFans, child. But yeah, definitely catch Bobby on the special. He ain't worth the $20, but if he keeps it down to $10 or whatnot, he's worth $10. Overall, Claudia did decent given the circumstances, but yeah, this crowd was too much for her, and Jason was just overall too messy. It's like Claudia was too posed, and I guess you would think that her posedness would have balanced out Jason's ratchetness, but overall, this was just a hot darn gone miss, child. Go hard going at it with darn gone Dimitri. Dimitri just shut down at this point, paying it dust. This is when darn gone Colgate darn gone goes over and gives him a hug. We now 27 minutes in, y'all. And I done already mentioned the Hot Wheels situation, so we're going to go ahead and skip through that. Meanwhile, darn going, Diggleine is just over it this whole time, honey. Diggleine is like, child, because once again, y'all got to take in consideration, they filmed this from like 5 p.m. and they didn't stop filming until like 3 in the morning the next day, and then they had to do some closing scenes. But pretty much they was there from like 2 in the afternoon to like 7 in the morning the next day. So they was there for like a solid 15 hours. Okay, we got Davion explaining his side. Allen Boy going off. Bobby talking about darn gone Allen Boy should have been called Miss Mama's. And shout out to Damien After Dark, honey. I watch his doggone reviews. And, honey, he touched on a good point about the bottom shaming. It's like, honey, y'all was in a house full of darn-gone bottoms for the most part. What is with all this darn-gone bottom shaming, child? Even the tops play with their darn-gone hind parts. Like, Rerun, honey, you go over to his channel. He's constantly offering free trials to his OnlyFans. Once again, y'all talking to the adult entertainment connoisseur, honey. I don't miss ish, honey. When he offered his free trials, honey, he's constantly in the shower playing with his hind parts and whatnot. You go over to Soul's stuff. He got the free version and where you can pay for videos. And then he got the one where it's $15 and you get all of the videos without having to pay for anything. Honey, he don't mind doing a little bit of dildo play in addition to messing with women. Because he's a full bi guy. Once again, people act like bi guys don't exist. I just had to do a video on August Icena and his seemingly coming out or whatnot. And people thinking that that was such a revelation when it was like, honey, we already knew about August Icena, T-Child. But yeah, darn going, so, honey, he gives you your money's worth. Now, his $15 subscription, honey, it's worth it, child. Now, Allen Boy, not so much, honey. The accusations is Allen Boy showing somebody else darn going hanky panky. And I don't know why, because from what we darn going can see a little bit, honey, he got a little something to work with, child. I don't know why he's darn going passing off other people's stuff as he is. It's not like he works a corporate job. Because whatever job he was working at that was paying $27 an hour, honey, he can't work that job no more, child. And that's about it for part two, honey. We get darn going, we get the folks going live, honey. Let me go ahead and insert part one where you have Trax, Crush, Big Burr, and Soul talking for 7 minutes.
Today, there's no more Chance.
Chance said it's not happening. Oh, Bad really? Boys, I mean, okay? The fuck? Like, what's going on with Bad Boys? The Lord knows what's happening with Bad Boys. Bring us back with the baddies and let us rock one more game.
Rashawn hot right now, so they're about to do that. Baddies is man.
Yo, we were Bad Boys. We got to accept that. We were Bad Boys.
That's why. That's why I said all the real hitters was on the Bobby show. I didn't do no fighting, but all the hitters was on the Bobby show.
Yeah, we were. It was Bad Boys Miami for the love of Bobby.
Hey, if they would have named it that, people wouldn't have been disappointed. Bad Boys.
Y'all see, I got these daddies in my house. Look at this daddy over there in my kitchen.
Bad Boys. Getting it together.
This is another daddy. Where's the other daddy at? Show your face.
Mm-hmm. They hit a button and got off of here.
What's up, y'all?
I would be surprised. If they were smart, they would follow this shit up real quick.
I'm gonna pin this for their ass. Well, not pin it, but let me drop this for y'all.
I'll pin it.
Of my name.
If the stars do align.
I'm ordering food.
Man, I'm glad.
I'm ordering food for sure.
I'm glad motherfuckers are still kicking. Hello? I'm glad y'all three still.
Can y'all hear me?
What's up, Celebrity Crush? What's going on?
Who, man?
When we all going to link up? I know y'all linked up and shit probably, but when can I get at it?
I'm so shady. What happened to Daddy?
No, so you need to try to come the first weekend in December. Is that still happening?
I mean, they haven't followed up with me, so that's why I haven't followed up with him.
Well, I mean, we still coming down though?
Or what? Yeah, I'm still coming.
Oh, I don't know nothing, but I can. I'll accept invite and come. Shit.
Yeah. Somebody must have called him.
December 2nd.
Oh, there you go. I mean, I would still come if you want to meet us up there, Mr. Soul Daddy.
What's up, Nigel?
On December 2nd.
Okay, where at? In ATL?
Mm-hmm.
Hell yeah.
I'm going from the 2nd to the 5th.
No, I would have been chill. I would have been yelling at them on Bad Boys. I wouldn't have been hitting them. I would have just been chill.
I think you would have hit. So you might have had to hit on Bad Boys.
Man, hey, that would have been cool, right?
They I don't know. I don't see nobody on even on Bad Boys. I don't see nobody trying soul.
I think me and Jonathan will get along, but he the only one I would be worried about.
That but like, even if it was a brand new person, I don't see no brand new motherfucker just trying you. You just don't give. Man, you don't give. You can try me.
Hey, Dre in here. What's up, bro?
I think I seen Rerun in this bitch.
Yeah, shout out to Rerun in the house.
My nigga, you still out the country, gang member? You still out the country?
Well, I said that earlier in my life. I was like, I need to live like Rerun. Rerun be out.
That's another
For real.
He come to LA.
Everybody be like, I'm trying to get like Soul trying to get like Rerun.
They got the same fucking face, yeah. That's big.
You know, hit me.
I appreciate y'all. Thank you. Hey, I seen Andre was out there eating ribs with Brazilians and shit.
Eating ribs and Brazilians?
With the Brazilians eating ribs and shit.
Nigga.
Yeah.
Bro, not the Brazilian ribs. You know, life.
New Year's that's how you live, bro. That's how you been. He done been around this shit. I'm new to this shit. So, I mean, you done been around this shit, Trax. You know what this shit like. I'm new to this shit, so I got to get used to this life.
I'm new to this.
Yeah, I wouldn't know. I just know Trax. Yeah, he done been on a few shows.
Right. Yeah, it's still new, man.
One thing I've always experienced is like other people getting that type of attention. So now that I'm getting this type of attention, it's like yeah. I be geeking with them. They be geeking at me and I'm geeking with them like
Bro said he had monkey.
They don't even know. That'd be the highlight of my day, them positive comments.
No, for real.
What does monkey taste like? Do it taste like oxtails?
He said he had monkey and snail.
Who's eating monkey?
Rosalie had monkey today.
I don't think he made he.
Oh, him in Brazil. Okay, yeah.
Not monkey though. That's low key like animal cruelty.
What's the monkey? She said, "Do we got OnlyFans?" I think Crush got it. Crush got OnlyFans.
And me and Burr on the way.
Yeah, let me know. So we can all do the windmill in the video for y'all.
Okay.
I had the situation. Yeah, she just called me. I think she outside. OnlyFans worthy.
Y'all want me? Y'all gonna have to pay.
Soul, stand up. Soul, stand up real quick. Stand up.
Gotta pay for him to stand up.
Why? What are we doing? my shirt a little sweaty because I be sweating a little bit.
Stupid.
I'm a grower, not a shower. If some of y'all can relate,
how? I don't understand that.
Like when they call me on the spot, like I'm glad I ain't have to like pull my shit out on the spot. I would have been like, give me 2 seconds.
You'd have been like this. Look, you'd have turned around like this.
Yeah, I would have been ooh, let me see something real quick. I got like, nah.
Give me a second. Shout out to Bo up in here. If y'all watch Rhythm and Flow, it's on there.
Somebody's from Rhythm and Flow is here.
Big Mouth Bo, y'all remember her?
Oh yeah.
Oh, okay, man. We see you, baby. Yeah. Oh yeah. Check them OnlyFans out. He said, "Boy, you better turn the AC up." I got on the heat. I only be sweating when I be like doing YouTube videos or getting recorded in Miami on the video. I be sweating. You know, I'm a sweater.
I'm a sweater.
They was like, nigga, you were sweating the whole season. I was like, right.
Me too.
It was hot, though. We was in Miami in the dead of the summer, though. It was hot. There was no air.
Man.
Boy.
He said, nigga, turn on the AC. I got on the heat. You in Brazil, brother. It's a little snow frost out there.
It's because when he's smelling pussy, he gets horny. Oh, my God, over here, too?
He should turn on the heat, boy. It is cold. Man, he in the Brazil. I bet he beneath the equator down there. He down there where it's hot.
Yo, I gotta get off this live and handle some shit. But we'll talk. I'm gonna watch the show. We'll get on after the live.
All right, after the show. Yeah, if y'all live after the show, I'm gonna jump on.
All right, let's text each other.
All right, y'all. Gang.
All right, I'm out.
Add me to your group chat. All right, y'all. I'm off. I keep it peaceful and I don't share info. God damn it. All right, I love you.
You are more than welcome.
Link in bio, gang.
All right, I'm gonna get off here too.
All right, brother.
Love you.
Love you too. Peace.
Y'all make sure y'all watch the reunion. The reunion is out now. I just ate a whole 4 for $4 online. And I'm about to go watch the episode. Why they got 7 people still trying to come up here? I'm about to go. Y'all go watch it. We're going to come back. We're going to come back in like an hour and a half, all right? All right.
So as y'all see from them talking, pretty much they just, you know, vibing, not really talking about much. Now, Diva Wine fell early. I dropped the ball. If they went live, honey, I missed it, honey. Y'all might have to go over to Even More Entertainment. And you know what? Unfortunately, and that's another thing that got me with monetization, honey. I got, this is how petty YouTube is. Diva Wine can't even promote the people no more. Ain't that something? See, now Diva Wine like to cite my sources. So it's like, now Diva Wine is stuck in between the rock and the hard place. And YouTube got to tell me something now. Because it's like, now, somebody like me, I like to give my folks shout-outs and stuff like that. Because I come from the realm of YouTube where, you know, we used to build each other up or whatnot. It's like, it didn't matter how many subscribers somebody else had. Because I come from the time back when I used to be in the hair community. And it was like, honey, it didn't matter whether it was Napatoria 85, whether it was darn on Kimmy Tube, Taryn Guy. They had like tens of thousands of subscribers. They would converse with us who only had like a couple hundred subscribers. And that was back during the days where you had video sharing. Yeah, you see, some of y'all might not know about that, but you could do a video response. And I ain't talking about, you know, they go to your channel. I'm talking about like you can literally pin your video underneath the other person's video if they had it where you can automatically do it. Or if they had it pending, that means that they had to manually approve it. But, honey, we used to do plenty of challenges with that back in the day. And that's how a lot of us was able to build each other's, you know, social medias up organically or whatnot. So we built genuine friendships and stuff through YouTube. And, yeah, sometimes it was a beneficial thing as far as monetization and trying to earn into the partnership program. Because that was during the time back when this was right before YouTube allowed everybody to become in. It's like you had to have consistently 10,000 plus viewers a month. You had to have like a unique metric, so growth or whatnot. You had to be very marketable and have a presence for YouTube to deem you like to be a partner. Like being a partner used to be a thing. Then they just was like, the heck with it. We just won't allow anybody, you know, to become monetized or whatnot. They did that around late 2012, early 2013, where they just, you know, did away with the partnership program as far as the random selection and just allowed everybody to come in. But yeah, it used to be built on back in the day where, you know, promoting other folks was encouraged. Now YouTube done got it where they was like, even if you have the people's permission. So even if I was to reach out to like Miss Wet Wet and Evermore, I can't consistently put they stuff in the channel anymore because that's considered like a form of promotion. And it's like, really? So, yeah, I'm just going to put when I edit this, I'm going to just put the names on the screen because now I'm being penalized. That was one thing that got me demonetized for a month was they said my reuse of content and not transform the video enough. And then number two, and that was only a handful of videos. They tried to say a majority of my content is like that, which is a lie because I got 1,000 videos on YouTube and the majority of my videos are me doing my vlogs. So it's like, how am I copyrighting my own self? The Bobby I Love You Purr videos, that only counts for like, what, baby 12 videos? And heck, most of that is just me talking. It's only like a handful of videos where I've done compilation clips. And it's like y'all didn't give me a warning or anything. Y'all just said, honey, we just going to take all the monetization, honey. And in addition to that, they said, oh, you can't darn gonna promote people like that anymore either. So they got me for compilation clips. And they got me for darn gonna overly promoting other folks. So now, for future reference, now we got to be cognizant of how we darn going put people's tags and stuff in the description box. So, yeah, that's why I'm just going to put their names on the screen and, you know, put their images or whatnot. Hopefully, they don't mind because I'm, like I said, I like to shout out my fellow people or whatnot. So, but, yeah, moving on from that, outside of Big Bird and them having a quick 7-minute live stream, we then get over to... I was going to post Hot Wheels, but Hot Wheels had some girl on there, and it's no shade to her. She's very gorgeous and whatnot, but I'm very cognizant of uploading images of people from other reality shows that I'm not reviewing. I got a feel that she was like from the Bad Girls Club or whatnot, and I don't have no shade with that, but it's like, I ain't trying to deal with no potential flagging issues with people not, you know, want they face on the Diva Wine channel. I can feel comfortable and say nobody has an issue with me over there at Bobby I Love You Purr, honey. I think it's safe to say Diva Wine is all right with the entire cast over at Bobby, even Bobby Lights, child. Only person might have an issue is Roland Ray, but I don't never feature Roland Ray, so I'm good on her, honey. But yeah, the only person from Bad Girls Club or Jocelyn Cabaret that y'all might see is Miss Wet Wet, honey. And even then, I ain't trying to do her no more either since she's came on YouTube. It's one thing when it's Instagram, but you know there's modesty. Like, it's a unspoken word of conduct that is just, unless you really know the person, you don't want to share images of your fellow YouTubers. Unless, like I said, you're really like this, or if they break the news or something. Like I said, since she is essentially like a public figure herself, I can get away with it. But just out of modest courtesy, I try to err on the side of caution. So anytime that she jumps on the live stream with them, same thing with Zeus Hottest Tea. I'm familiar with all the folks, honey. But because we're on the same platform and avenue, that's why I omit those types of videos, just out of a common courtesy or whatnot. But the other one was Big Burr. Big Burr went live a couple times. Big Burr went live with Davion, a.k.a. The Handler. And pretty much he gave his summary of the Hot Wheels situation all over again. And it's like, child, I'm about tired of this darn-gone love triangle-ish. Hell, a love square situation. Honey, I wish darn-gone Spice would make a remix of this right here. But let me go ahead and let y'all watch this 15 minutes, and then I'm going to close it on out.
You know, he got him one. Like, he got
But see, here's my thing, though. That was so, not to take away from that moment, but it was so minor compared to everything that is going on. Like, I feel like that moment, I don't think you lost anything. I don't think you look bad. I don't think you lost anything. I don't feel like, naturally, if somebody hit me, I'd be upset too, but I feel like you were a victim. That's just the way I feel. From the Jameson stuff to that part, all of it was corny to me, right? Okay, let me say this. Dingling is my bro. We cool, right? I'm cool with everybody. But I thought that was whack. I thought that was really whack because I don't like the fact that Tony can, like, antagonize people, do all these things, and then when it comes to him attacking someone, then other people jump in for him and attack other people. I just thought that was kind of whack, right?
Right.
I think that Dingling probably had other motives. He was mad about other stuff, so whatever it was, but it's just, for me, it's like the fact that you popped in, okay, looking bomb, okay, popped in there like, nigga, you weren't even on the cast, and you really, like, from beginning to end were a huge part of this whole show.
Yeah.
Like, that's like a first, right? So, to me, that's crazy in its own, but to come out and then you trying to explain your side and tell your story, people are so bothered and so scared about what's going to come out. They wouldn't let you talk.
Mm-mm.
it's just this, like, the last episode was like, okay, but today's episode, like, really fucked with me because it was just a lot going on.
Right.
It was a lot going on. I feel like Tony got checked several times. Okay. So he didn't like that. When you came out, he was clearly bothered and left. And so I just feel like, you know, I hope you don't feel embarrassed or feel like, you know, somebody got one over on you, because at the end of the day, the world knows, everybody watching knows you were in the right.
I mean, I'm not, well, it's a little embarrassed. The only thing that I'm embarrassed about is how my face looked when he hit me. But other than that, like, life goes on, like I said, like, and I still look good. Like, you know, I was stressed out before the reunion and coming to the reunion. So my skin was breaking out. I was emotional at the reunion. Like, I still tried to keep a smile on my face at the end of the day. And like I said, I never had a problem with Trizzy. Like, outside the show, like, our DMs, he would always try to be a friend and always pretend like he was my friend. So it was like, even when he hit me, it was more so shocking versus me like, oh, I gotta fight him. No, I was more so shocked because I'm like, I didn't have a problem with him. So I thought that he was actually going to pull Tony away from me. Mm-hmm. I didn't think that he was going to hit me. So that's another reason why I was confused, because I'm like,
right,
bitch, you just hit me for what? Like, I could see if I put my hands on him, but it was like, I didn't even do nothing to him. I was not going to do nothing to him, but he could roll up on me and try to put his hands on me, and I still wasn't going to hit him. And I get still knocked in my shit. Like, the fuck?
Yeah.
But like I said, like, life is still good. Life's still going on. Yeah, he bust my lip. My lips still look good. Face still look good.
Okay.
He fighting bigger battles right now. I think he got cancer, whatever the case may be, whatever he say. Yeah. So it's like, people are really unhappy in their lives, and they want to bring everybody else down with them. And regardless of what the people say, like, I'm not supposed to be there and I'm not supposed to speak my truth. Like, throughout the show, they accused me of having sexual relations with multiple people. That was my main thing that I didn't have, like, I wasn't comfortable with. So that's another reason why I found my way getting there, whatever, is because I wanted to address the fact that, no, I did not have sexual relationships with, like, multiple people.
Right.
And Hot Wheels was supposed to be my friend, but you never once hear him say, oh, no, Davion wasn't messing with this person. Davion wasn't messing with that person. The only thing you hear is him letting them continue with the rumors and the allegations, and it's like, but you're supposed to be my friend, though. And then even I can man up and own to the fact that, okay, yeah, I had dealings with Jameson. But what the people don't realize is I didn't approach Jameson. I didn't have sexual relationships with Jameson inside that house, nor did I continue. I didn't continue to – well, it was a two-person thing. Like, it take two to tango.
So facts.
It was like, when I got back to Houston, Jameson still pursued me.
Right.
Just as well as Trizzy seen me at Jameson's house. So he know what was going on just as well before the reunion. Mm-hmm. And so that's why I said it was more so of a shocking situation for him to put his hands on me.
Right.
Being that we were in the same settings multiple times before the reunion.
Right.
You knew I was at Jameson's house. You knew me and Jameson were dealing with each other just as well. But they continue on to carry this narrative as if, oh, they really fuck with Bobby or they care about Bobby. Y'all, they never once cared about Bobby. Because if you cared about Bobby, you would have went back and told him the day that you seen me at Jameson's house. But instead of him doing that, bitch, you look for a moment for Hot Wheels to put your hands on me. Just as well as what the people don't know is, that's why I kept saying Hot Wheels, you was calling, he kept calling the police. They did not want me at the reunion. I repeat, they did not want me at the reunion, to the fact that Hot Wheels was calling the police making fake allegations towards me, at this point putting my freedom in jeopardy just to stop me from coming to the reunion.
Wow.
That's like what was really going on behind the scenes.
It was so that deep?
It was that deep yes, they were calling the police on me. I have screenshots of the police reports. I had to call the police and address these same police reports that he made against me. So at this point, yes, this is my real life. Like, and yes, that's why another reason why I had to go to the reunion, because I had to defend the fact that all the allegations that were being made towards me. Mm-hmm. And if I'm wrong for that, then like, so be it. Like, if I had to get punched in the face for that, then so be it.
I'm glad you came to the reunion, because I feel like
Terrell said add him up.
Oh yeah, let me add bro. I feel like, hey, you send a request, bro. Or let me I feel like you,
and then I'm a sweet person, like,
right,
I'm a sweet person. Like, I wasn't trying to piss anybody off. I wasn't trying to fight anybody.
Yeah, it's whole not letting me know you was on Bird Live.
Bird had just went live.
I just
got up here. But it is what it is. Yeah. Like, and I'm still happy. Like,
this Devion night, we're gonna let him get everything off, because they literally just wrote me and they was like, y'all need to talk about it. So you need to let them know that they really didn't want him coming to the reunion, y'all. They tried to make they tried to get a restraining order. Fake Wheels, the one with no legs, tried to get a restraining order against him to keep him from coming to the reunion, because he didn't want him to tell the truth.
That he was literally famous and homeless.
That's real crazy that you would go to those extremes. Yeah.
Because here's my thing. Like, at the end of the day, everything that happened in the house was going to get talked about no matter what, because of the reunion, right? So, obviously, they gave us that platform to come to the reunion and talk about everything. I don't think they knew you were coming, so that was probably number one shock. And one thing that I have watched, and I say this a lot, I watched him turn his back on you, how he was turning his back on you, real, and you. I watched you fight for him in that house several times, get emotional over him several times. And then you, Devion, coming to the house with him and helping him out that whole time and then turning on you, that just speaks volumes to me. Me and him have had, like, our back and forth. Like, we're not, like, I don't hate him, but I know, obviously, like, he don't fuck with me, which is fine. But I just find it odd that people keep defending him, and he clearly has, like, turned on people.
I find it odd that he would go against us, people that he'd been knowing 10-plus years, or people he'd been knowing 2-3 months. I just think that's so delusional and so weird and just random. I mean, I know why they turned against me, for clout, clearly, because I haven't done nothing to nobody on the cast, but it's just strange. It's like, how could you, in your right mind as a grown-ass man, even feel close enough or trust these people that you've only been knowing a few months to turn on the people that you've been knowing years?
You never see Trizzy while Trizzy talking shit. Bitch, you never see Trizzy hopping not one of Hot Wheels fights the whole season. You never see Trizzy jump in and do shit while people questioning me why I didn't jump in and hit Ray. Ray is in a wheelchair. What the fuck do I look like putting my hands on Ray? That's so fucked up. Like, this world we live in is fucked up. And it's fucked up because they make stuff okay for Hot Wheels to do it. But,
bitch, right.
Hot Wheels could do anything. Hot Wheels could get away with murder, and it don't be a problem. But when it comes to everybody else and all the situations that got him revolved around it, like, he gets away with it. And that's fucked up.
That was probably one of my only things that I
didn't know happened. I don't give a fuck about him. He's a fake-ass bitch. Like I said, he turned on me. Bitch, you would still be stuck in Miami to this day if it wasn't for me, ho. Paying for your flight and your bags back home, bitch. Don't ever, 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 ever play with me, okay? Ever.
I'm never that bitch is okay.
For real.
So
that's why that bitch in a wheelchair now, half dead. No spline, spleen, having that. So I can't wait till that bitch croco, but I don't care.
Okay. For me, it was the part where he said, Bobby said, Island Boy had low vibrational dick, okay? He said the dick was small. Was he just talking shit, or is the dick small, bro? Is it low vibrational?
Why do I have to answer that question?
Because nobody else knows.
I'm not about to answer that question.
Okay, I ain't gonna make you do that.
We not about to make this about Jack's
meat. Okay, okay.
Bitch, was the dick big or not?
I thought you seen it.
I seen a picture. Y'all been saying he been catfishing the girls.
Oh! I mean, I seen the picture of him in some underwear, but I don't know, you know.
It's giving this little light.
Y'all talking about that's not nice to say. Y'all don't want me to say the truth.
This little light of mine. But you know what?
Yeah, and it is crazy because
it makes sense.
I'm still in a happy place though. Like at the end of the day,
yes,
like,
baby, I'm tapping them fat black chocolate cheeks.
I'm gonna change
her name from Island Boy to Bahama Mama.
Okay.
So.
And I'm just glad that this is over. Like, I'm glad bitches got their moment of fame. Now, we're going to see where they are, you know, a year from now or some months from now. Because bitches swear they're getting on another show. Bitches swear that they got things going on.
Oh, y'all want to talk about the cabin trip? That's how we need to talk about this cabin trip. Yes, we just had the legendary cabin trip that the girls will be mad about.
Baby.
What's like cabin trip?
A trip where you go make a lot of baggage and footage.
Oh, okay. That's dope.
They said he was hooked on Jameson. I wasn't hooked on Jameson. Jameson was hooked on me.
They know what it is.
This is what I don't like. When people try to jump into somebody else's like conversation or business, which obviously this is all public, we're on TV, but making assumptions like, motherfuckers be in relationships all the time. People like each other. We're with somebody. Like, that's just natural life. But when somebody's lying to you and lying to somebody else, like, you can't be at fault for that. So, like, people talk what you know. Like, the jokes and all that is great. And they're trying to be funny and shit like that. But these people's real lives, though. So, like, be realistic here.
Most definitely. And then, too, like I said, I never did TV before. So, Jameson was kind of manipulating
the situation. Tag up my OnlyFans. If y'all want the cabin trip, it's there on the OnlyFans. My OnlyFans. It's going to be free for like 30 minutes. So y'all go run it up and go subscribe. Okay. Link it. The pinned tweet is pinned.
Oh, girl. Girl, we know you did your cabin trip, girl.
Baby, they asking about it.
You're not playing with that cabin trip.
Girl.
Okay, yeah, I'm sorry, brother.
No, that episode, I mean...
I know you gotta get your coins, bitch. Get your coin. Yes, ma'am. But, yeah, this is our real life. This is our real life, and yes, I was in a, like, situationship with him, and he manipulated me to think that this was just for TV.
As y'all seen, honey, the handler was just pretty much reiterating the same old go-to of how him and Alan Boyle was darn gone conversing this, that, and the third, and now, what we trying to figure out is how long it took from... See, is this overlapping? Because now we found out during the interview, Go Hard was messing around with Sap. And hell, and actually, darn, Dimitri called it, honey. Dimitri called it. Now, y'all can say Dimitri is wrong with his approach, but honey, Dimitri ain't tell no lies. Dimitri said half of them mugs was some hoes. A lot of y'all was messing around in the hotel before y'all even got with Bobby. Some of y'all is here to boost y'all OnlyFans. And once again, where was the lie? Because now, like, nine out of the 15 cast members got OnlyFans. And they're promoting their OnlyFans like crazy. And then you got Savage messing around with Darwin Cash before they even got in the house. And then it developed into like a somewhat of a relationship brewing, talking about they want to continue this after they get on off the show. Then it was going to be a potential, you know, three-way with him, Davion, and Cash. But the other two is the 9-3 way, honey. Gohard came out and said he could have messed around with both of them. Then it developed into the brotherly relationship with Jameson. Jameson, who was at a time messing and had an intimate thing going on, even after the show ended, he had a situationship with Davion. And then they eventually broke it off. They was all over there with Hot Wheels. Diggling and all them is all in the same domain, the house and whatnot. And then you now Allen Boy and Nargo and Cash is in a relationship. It's like all this overlapping for me, honey. Davion and Savage are besties. Diggling tried to accuse the besties of making out on his bed, which was deemed a lie, honey. But neither here nor there, Savage was still messing around with Nargo and Cash. Allen Boy was messing around with Davion. Now Allen Boy and Dargon Cash is an item. Child, if Savage, I mean, if Dargon Spice Official from Love and Hip Hop Atlanta don't make a Dargon remix of this, like she did that connection with Dargon Black China, messing around with Rob after Dargon Kendall, after Kylie or Kendall, one of them Dargon Jenna girls messed around with Dargon Tiger or whatnot. The way that Dargon Spice put that together was Dargon hilarious. Honey, we need somebody to make the Dargon gay version of that with Dargon this situation. And then, unbeknownst to us, Allen Boy is the winner. And up until this moment, Dargon Bobby don't know that Allen Boy, because he Dargon thinking Allen Boy and Dargon the handler, aka Davion, still has something going on. But unbeknownst to him, honey, Allen Boy, at this point in time, is now in a situationship with Dargon Gohard. And on part three that's coming up, you crying to Gohard talking about you thought he had your back. Little do you know, he's Dargon rubbing Dargon Allen Boy's back, the person that you Dargon chose, honey. I was like, if this ain't some karma all the way around, if this, honey, this is Dargon more complicated than Triangle on YouTube, honey. The Love Triangle. I was like, child, Tyler Perry couldn't even wrote this Dargon script, honey. Because now, Bobby, you can't be too upset because you was letting Dargon Andre, your ex, hit it on the first night. And even leading up to the reunion, you was doing these Dargon theatrics, Dargon in the pool with Rerun and all this, that, and the third. Trying to act like you done chose your old thing. And the gag is, your old thing was not even an old thing. That was a Dargon stunt, honey. Child, boo. This whole situation is a hot, funky, Dargon scripted, Dargon gay soap opera, Dargon mess, and I'm here all the way for it, honey. But y'all leave y'all thoughts down below. Honey, this part three is going to be interesting because Bobby going to get knocked down. Honey, some of that Dargon filler is going to be rearranged, honey, between Dargon Diggling hitting him. Who else hit him, honey? I want to say two people managed to Dargon knock the mess up out of Bobby, honey. And here we was thought Miss Mama's was going to do something, honey. Miss Mama's girl, I was rooting for you, Cam. You didn't do Sugar Honey Iced Tea, honey. You got your behind Dargon whooped by Dargon Cash, honey. I thought you would at least Dargon tap Dargon Bobby's face one good time. You didn't tap Bobby's face. You was copping please, this, that, and the third. Cam, I was so Dargon disappointed in you, girl. Who else? Oh, somebody Dargon. Who? Diggly, why in the world you Dargon pop Dargon Davion? Like, that wasn't even your... I understand that you was frustrated. I don't know if it's the radiation getting to you. And I'm not joking, because there's somebody who's done gone through that. It's like, I ain't trying to make no C jokes on the C word. But it's like, I don't know if the treatments was getting to you or whatnot. But you done went and popped Dargon Davion in the mouth, girl. And then we hear that after recording, Davion got his hit back on Dargon Hot Wheel. He was like, oh, you had your friend over here hit me in my mouth, honey. He done went and done bopped Dargon Hot Wheels upside the head when the cameras weren't rolling. That used to be, and then it was like, the gag is, this was the person that brought you on to the darn show as the hired help, and you was helping yourself to everybody else, child. Like I said, you can't even make this up, honey. Even Tyler Perry, crafty darn behind, couldn't even darn write this darn type of script up, honey. Ruthless don't have nothing on this darn ruthless situation of the Bad Boys Miami. This is what it should have been called, like Damien at the Dark said, honey. This should have been Bad Boys Miami, honey. But Bobby, I Love You Per, the reunion, part two, child. I look forward to darn part three, honey. And this, and you know, I will try to stay up doing part three, honey. I'm going to try my best, because part three is when the fights and stuff gets in. So I'm going to darn go to sleep early in the day. That way I can be up through the night, because y'all know they be up quite a bit, honey. 1-2 o'clock in the morning. So I'm going to try my best. And then even after I wake up, some of them be darn starting up the live streams early in the morning. I remember the last, for part one, as soon as I tried to start editing, I had to stop editing, right? I had to stop editing because Dimitri done went live with darn Hot Wheels. So I had to add that clip on in. But yeah, I'm going to tough it out. We only got one more episode to go. So with that being said, y'all, feel free to like, comment, share, and subscribe. And I will see y'all soon with more videos. Mwah.
Bitch, I had them big ass Balenciagas on. I have my motherfucking gold chains on, bitch. Please. Bitch, these real diamonds. That hoe is not fit to tear my clothes up. Tell none of my jewelry off. Or none of that. I don't give a fuck. And that's not why I was there. I was there to tell my story. And it was like, I never could tell my story because bitches was too busy trying to punch on me. But, and then too, I never knew that Trizzy was about to hit me. Like, we never had a problem with each other. So I thought he was about to pull Hot Wheels away from me. But instead, the bitch hit me. But it's cool or whatever. Like, I'm not upset or whatever. Like, it's life. Like, he got his one. And bitch, if we ever cross paths again, bitch, it's up. And that's all I'm gonna say. It's up or whatever. And that's cool. But other than that, like,
bitch, you?
I was not, huh?
I said, bitch, I'm scared of you.
Bitch. But I'm not, like, I'm not a miserable person. Like, I'm not upset. And, like, I don't care if it's on TV. Like, I'm still not upset. Like, bitch, life is good. Hot Wheels forever gonna be in that wheelchair. So she gonna forever be a mad ass bitch. She gonna forever talk all this shit. Then I don't understand how come that bitch could roll up on me and try to aggress me. Bitch, I still have the scar on my face from when this bitch hit me in the face with a cell phone off camera. So it's just like, this bitch could constantly roll up and do whatever he wants to me. But it's like, if I put my hands back on him, then I'm the bad guy. Like, that's fucked up. And it is what it is or whatever. And Trizzy still ain't fucking with me on my worst day. And yeah, I was looking a little raunchy on that camera, but bitch, please. Bitch, I'm it. Bitch, I'm lit. The fuck? I still look good. Like I said, skin look good, bitch, face look good. It's whatever. Like, and I don't give a fuck.
Y'all are here getting it done. I've been watching y'all show with that bird, and yes, I mean, that was some weak ass shit. And I just feel like you need to get y'all one because, yeah, no. Fuck no. We don't do that sneaky shit.
And then y'all seen the security run right in between us before anything. Like, it wasn't like I was going to be able to get his ass right back right then and there anyways. Like, the fuck? But like I said, bitch, I'm still cute. I still look good. And bitches were still mad. And it is what it is.
Facts. But, you know, y'all keep popping y'all sheets. Y'all doing y'all thing. Y'all doing y'all thing. I fucks with y'all show. I fucks with everybody on the show. Yeah.
Then you heard the bitch say, oh,
you too. Body,
if you touch my wheelchair, my body will hurt. Any little touch of his wheelchair, his body hurt. But, bitch, you rose up to try to motherfucking attack me. Now, if I would have knocked you in your shit, then I would be considered the bad person, though. And your body will be hurting, though. But it's just like, everything that a hoe say is very contradicting. Like, a bitch could put their hand in me. A bitch could try to roll up on me. But if I do it, then I'm considered whatever they want to consider me as. But I don't give a fuck.
Like, my opinion, Everybody see what's going on the show. Facts, wheelchair or no wheelchair. If you run up on me, facts, I'm going to hit you. I'm going to beat your motherfucking ass. See, I'm going to flip you the fuck up out that motherfucker.
Right.
Because